Right, friends, welcome back to Second Capsule. This is the annual report on economy submitted by the Reserve Bank of India. Please don't forget, the accounting year for Reserve Bank of India is from July 1 to June 30. Please don't forget, financial year is from April 1 to March 31. The accounting year for Reserve Bank of India is from July 1 to June 30. After the end of each accounting year, Reserve Bank of India, Central Board of Directors submit the report to central government as per Article 53(2) of Reserve Bank of India Act 1934. So this is all about annual report on economy submitted by Reserve Bank of India, and please don't confuse with the financial stability report submitted by Reserve Bank of India once in 6 months. That is different, and this is different. This talks about the macroeconomic situation of the previous financial year and the prospects for the current financial year, and that means overall the status of economy from July 1 to June 30. That is annual report on economy. Right, friends, what are the important points? GDP growth prospects for 2016-17 are brighter than that in 2015-16. What are the reasons? The reasons are better monsoon. This year monsoon is much better than last 2 years, 2014 and 2015. We have seen two successive deficient monsoons, and now the monsoon is expected to be normal. So because of better monsoon, GDP growth prospect for this year is expected to be better than the previous year. Implementation of 7th pay commission recommendations, that means more money in the hands of employees, which will result in more demand. Because of more demand, GDP will grow. Then public investment take off in some sectors. Public investment, that means the investment by the government departments, has taken off. One classic example is highways sector. Then optimism created due to GST. Actually, GST may benefit GDP only in the long run. In the short run, it may not benefit. But optimism created is more important than the reality. And overall, gross value added is expected to grow at 7.6%. But this is still below the level the country is capable of. The country is capable of growing at more than 8%, but it is not able to grow at that level. But even then, this year's prospects are much better than last year. And you may ask, what is meant by GVA? You will get GDP if indirect taxes are added to GVA by subtracting subsidies. That means the GDP is equal to gross value added plus indirect taxes minus subsidies. We will discuss in detail when we are discussing economy. And look into the second one, weak points to growth. Private sector investment is not taking off, and capacity utilization is also less in private sector. What is meant by capacity utilization? If a steel plant has got a capacity of 3 million tons, and because of a lack of demand, if it is producing only 2 million tons, then you can say it is less capacity utilization. The capacity created is more than what is being produced. That is known as low capacity utilization. Then slow public investment in some sectors. Public investment has taken off in some sectors like highways and railways, but it has not taken off in other sectors. Then all of you are well aware, structural bottlenecks are there in our economy. So these are the weak points which are flagged by the Reserve Bank of India in its annual report. If you look at the third point, inflation projections are still at the upper limit of RBI's inflation objective. Please don't forget, RBI's inflation objective is 5% by March 2017. And at the same time, government has also given inflation target of 4% plus or minus 2%, which is valid up to March 2021. So RBI's internal target is 5%, government's target is 4% plus or minus 2%. The headline inflation is expected to reach that level of 5% by the last quarter of the year. But at the current juncture, the upside risks are there. At present, the consumer price index based inflation is hovering around 6%, and RBI feels it may come down to around 5% by the end of this financial year. What I mean to convey is, though the upside risks are there at present juncture, but by the end of this financial year, it may come to somewhere around 5%. Looking to the next one, number of stalled projects came down. This is because of government's initiative during the past 1 year. The stalled projects, you may ask, what is meant by stalled project? Project which was stopped due to one or the other reason. Stalled projects have came down during the past 1 year. 592 projects were stalled as on March 31, 2015. With a value of rupees 9 lakh crore. During the past 1 year, they came down to 404 projects, and at present, the value of the stalled projects is rupees 6 lakh crores. This shows some important decisions were taken by the government to resolve the stalemate. Right? This is a very good sign as far as the economy is concerned. Another important aspect as per the annual report is monetary transmission has not taken place. All of you are well aware, repo rate was reduced by 150 basis points during the past 1.5 years. But the base rate of the banks, please don't forget, from April 1, base rate is replaced by MCLR. If you look at the median base rate of banks, it got reduced by 60 basis points only, and the median term deposit rates reduced by 92 basis points only. When Reserve Bank of India is reducing repo rate by 150 basis points, it is not transmitting either into the deposit rates or into the interest rates of loans. So this is the very important point flagged by Reserve Bank of India. RBI has proposed peer-to-peer lending platform to be regulated as NBFCs. In recent times, this peer-to-peer lending platform, it is a crowdfunding online lending platform where the lenders and the borrowers will be brought together, and it is unsecured finance. There are a lot of risks associated with it. Under these circumstances, RBI wants to regulate peer-to-peer lending as non-banking financial companies. Next one, in small borrower accounts, you may ask what is meant by small borrower accounts. The accounts where the loan value is up to rupees 2 lakhs, where the individual loan value is up to rupees 2 lakhs, that is known as a small borrower account. And if you look at the small borrower accounts in rural areas as well as urban areas, in rural areas, for every 100 small borrower accounts held by rural men, rural women account for 32 accounts. That means 100 borrowers, if they are men, then 32 women are there in rural areas. If you look at the comparison in urban areas, for every 100 small borrower accounts held by urban men, urban women constitute just 16 accounts. So, rural women are better off when you look at the loans from banks are concerned. Look at the last point. Cyber security lab is proposed by RBI. RBI is worried about the cyber security. All the commercial banks other than regional rural banks and local area banks will be brought under supervisory program for assessment of risk and capital framework, or otherwise known as a SPARC, from 2016-17. So this will be implemented somewhere during this financial year 2016-17. Right, friends, these are the important aspects of RBI's annual report. Let me reiterate, this is submitted by Reserve Bank to central government once in a year after the end of accounting year as per Article 53(2) of RBI Act 1934. Right, friends, with this, let us conclude second capsule. Please do join for third one. Have a nice day. Thank you.